Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we, the team of NMEICT, are here to present our application, ANGLE, which stands for Analytics of Group Learning Environment. I would like to present my project team. We have Apurv Tandon, Chirag Khandelwal, Kunal Agarwal, Manushi Banwal, me, that is Oishi Poddar, Prateek Paralia, Rohit Kumar, and Sakshi Sachar. So the aim of our project was to build a web application that can be used to build, form effective collaborative learning groups in an online environment for free and cater to real-world problems. Our application has been provided with a host of group learning tools which can be used to enhance your virtual learning experience. Each of these tools are equipped to analyze in depth the participation and performance of each of your group members. The USP of our application is the flexibility in which groups can be created and customized, as well as tool selection and personalization of profiles with access rights to each of these tools. This is our target audience. Application can be used, has a wide scope of users. Learners can use it, as well as educators, institutions, friends, and businesses. Some of the features of our platform are creating customizable groups, discovering other study groups, viewing and editing your profile, blended learning, which is integration of a host of tools on one platform, forming peer-to-peer learning groups, mentor-to-student learning groups, and performance and participation tracking. These are some of the available group learning tools on our platform. We have notes through which we can share resources, quiz and assignment through which we can test our knowledge, polls from where we can collect a generalized idea of all our users, group discussion forum on which we can discuss and consult with our peers or mentors, and video conference and chat where we can talk face to face. Some of the use cases of our application include implementation of CS101, that is language-based grouping. So recently we found out that Dr. Fatik sir takes this course CS101 and teaches programming in basics to first year students. So he faces some problems with students who come from various states across the country and have some problems in speaking or understanding English. So he even needs to take classes in Hindi. So we decided that we implement CS101 and solve the CS101 problem using our application. Some of the other use cases are CS101 institute-based grouping, online coaching where mentors can teach students via our application, and pre-joining training by companies. So right now we are going to show you a demo of how our application can be used to solve the CS101 problem. I now call upon Sakshi Sachar to show you the demo.
So as my teammate explained that CS101 is an amalgamation of students belonging to diverse groups. So conceding Professor Fatak's methodology of language-based segregation of students, we, the NMEICT team, has implemented a flexible and an efficient solution to this problem. Currently, we have 100 members registered in this application, and the admin profile is visible here. So the admin has created a group called CS101. CS101 is the main group, and it has three subgroups: English programmers, Hindi programmers, and Marathi programmers. So basically, the users can join any of these subgroups depending on the language they feel proficient in. So English, Hindi, and Marathi will be the mode of instruction, or will be the mode of basic interaction, which will be done inside the group. So we have different features like discussion forum, so the discussion and all those things can be corresponding to each of these languages. Each is a public group, and the group is searchable by the group name. And the flexibility of this module is that the groups are customizable, and the tools can be chosen at the time of group creation, and the roles of each of the members of the group can be defined at the time of group creation. Now moving on to the English programmers group, this is the admin profile. The admin can view all the members of the group and can change the access site of each of the members. So as you all can see, Manushi Banwal is a TA in the English programmers group. And she is a member of the English programmers group and is automatically a member of CS101. So now we will see how the access rights of a TA are different from that of the normal users, a student or an admin. So this is the group page of Manushi Banwal. She is a TA, so she can create an assignment, she can grade an assignment, and a list of all the assignments which were posted during the tenure of CS101 is visible here. Also, a list of all the submissions is displayed. Corresponding to each submission, the TA who graded each of the assignment is visible. Submitted file is there. The TA can update the marks. Can also, and now the next feature is a quiz. A TA can create a quiz, schedule a quiz, and it can be used as an efficient method to track the performance. Also, a TA can initiate a video chat. As soon as the video chat is initiated, it is added in the activity list of the group. The video chat will be topic-wise, and this can help in a better analysis of the group. Also, we have a feature of creating a poll. A poll can be used to get an overall idea about the group. A TA can come to know that whether a student has understood a topic or not by creating and the anonymity of the user is maintained whenever a user votes for a poll. The next feature is notes. A note can be used for sharing all the resources, and the study material can be shared among all the group members. We also have a discussion forum in our application. For discussion forum, we have used an open source application, JForum, and a single sign-on has been implemented. So the user is automatically logged into the JForum, and all the groups of which he is a member of is displayed, and corresponding to each group, a list of topics which are currently active in that group is also visible. And this user can participate in any of these threads and can put up the queries, and the TA can answer to any of the queries which were posted by the students in each of these groups.
Just a small interruption to just tell Nagesh what it is. Actually, what we are doing is, okay, we are taking the full set of 500 CS students. We are slicing and dicing them according to language. Not only that, we are slicing and dicing the 40 odd TAs that are there, depending on their language. So we are forming that subgroup, and we are saying that these TAs are responsible for the Hindi programming group. Now they can add their own quizzes, they can add their own assignments, they can add their own discussions. They are responsible to bridge the gap between the low understanding of English of that group and what CS101 keeps going on its own. So this is additional information, additional learning that is required because of that language slicing. We can also slice and dice the group based on higher performers, lower performers as the class is going on. So higher performers group can have separate set of TAs, they will have more difficult problems. The low performers group can be segregated and assigned a certain set of TAs. So it's basically as the course is progressing, I can slice and dice it, make it into a different manageable thing with its own set of discussion forums, own set of quizzes, own set of videos. And then I can monitor whether the Hindi group has come up to speed or Tamil group has come up to speed, what is being done by Hindi people, what is being done by Tamil people, so that we can share best practices and keep doing that. So that is the basic purpose of that. So all the other tools are available, they are managed separately. The TAs have got that thing, the admin person also has got that. This is not the current thing is not meant to teach CS101. It's meant to augment the teaching of CS101 through external means. Maybe for smarter people, dumber people, language people, whichever. Go ahead.
Now this is the admin profile. The user is currently logged in as admin, so he can see a list of all the activities which are scheduled in this group, all the group posts which were done during the tenure of the group. Now we'll switch to the student profile. Basically, the idea was the creation of groups, customizable groups based on, at the time of group creation, the user can select from the list of features which are available, and the access rights of each of the members can be defined at the time of group creation. So now this is a student dashboard. So Aruna is a student in this group, and she is a member of English Programmers group, and she is also a part of CS101. And within this is a group page. And a student can submit an assignment, can submit a quiz, and a list of all the quizzes which are scheduled for the next 7 days is visible, can answer a poll, and if the poll has not been answered, then it is available, can participate in discussion forum, can post a reply to the queries which are posted by other members of the group. This facilitates a healthier interaction among students. Also, code snippets can be shared. And now, we come to the next feature of our application for which Angle stands, analytics of group learning environment. So, since this is the admin login and the admin has the right to view the analytics of all the group, all corresponding to each feature of our application, the admin and the TA has the right to view all the analytics. So now I would like to call upon Manushi to throw some light on the analytics of CS101 group, which is actually a six week course, and we have implemented it in its mid.
Let's have a look on the analytics part, which our application provides on various tools. So first tool is the notes. This graph shows the number of posts which has been posted by each user in a particular group. Like Bindal has posted 3, Kaustav has posted 8 number of notes in that group. Moving towards the next tool, that is assignment, this graph shows the number of submissions per each assignment. That is the number of students who have posted or submitted the assignment. For example, PLSQL assignment has 6 submissions. This is the toppers list, which will show you the toppers of each assignment, including the grades. Like NP hard assignment, Sarthak Raina has got 99 marks, which is the highest. This graph is the topic wise analysis of each of the assignment. The bar shows the average grade which was obtained in each of the assignment. Like 51 is the average mark of assignment string processing. This graph is the total analysis of the grades of each assignment. Blue bar shows the maximum grade, red shows the minimum, and the green shows the average grade of each assignment.
Now we move on to the poll analysis. This graph shows us the number of voters and non-voters of a particular poll. In the green we have the count of the voters, and in the red we have the count of the non-voters of the poll. In this poll we have 17 users and 36 non-voters. Here we have the overall result of the poll, where we can select one of the poll and see the replies of the users of that group. Here the poll is about which is the easier algorithm out of the sorting, all this sorting algorithm. Then we find out that insertion sort has been voted as the easiest one. Similarly, this is the other question. Now we go to the quiz analytics. Here are the total marks versus each of the user. We can know how much have the users scored in all of the quizzes till now. Here Pranab has scored only 3 marks and Pankti has scored over 10 marks in all of the quizzes. This is the data of the quiz overall. What is the minimum, average and the maximum marks scored in that quiz? Now we come to the analytics of the discussion forum. We can see the post-wise analytics of all the discussion posts and the replies to it, and how many people have participated and not participated in that post. We can see the participants also of each of the posts. Like in this, these many people have not participated and all these have participated in the post. Here is the analysis of how many posts have been posted for this discussion forum and how many users have been participating in this forum. So in the left we have the number of replies, and in the right, that is in the green color, we have the number of participants for this post.
So moving towards the next tool, that is video conference. This graph is the topic wise analysis of the conference. The blue bar shows the time devoted to each of the conference, and the green bar shows the total number of conference held on that particular topic. Next is a pie chart, which will show the topic wise attendance report. The red will show you the absentees of the conference, and the blue is the will show the percentage of user which were present at that conference. We can also select various topics and see their respective attendance report. That's all for the analytics of our application.
So that was the slicing and dicing based on language. Now we will show you a demo of how we can slice and dice based on institute. So what our application could be used for is setting up remote centers in educational institutions across the country, and teachers from IIT Bombay could use our application to teach them in these various educational institutions. So now I would call Chirag and Apoor to come and show us the demo.
Now we will continue with the live demo of CS101 institution based grouping. So we will quickly start with creating a group name, that institution based. Here we have two options, that is a group status, public or private. Public group can be seen by anyone and anyone can join. And for private group, one has to get the permission from the admin. Also for group type, we have peer-to-peer and mentor and student. In peer-to-peer, everyone will be given equal access right. And for mentor and student, it will be like hierarchical. So this is a flexible feature, that is profiles which you want to include. That we are including admin. These are the access right given to each profile. We can also change the right and create our own profile. Now we will create a profile as some institution TA. This TA will manage the NIT's students, that he can create assignments and all, create quiz, but grading option will be given to the teacher of that institute. Also a default profile is there by which anyone will join. Later the admin can change the default profile of anyone. Now creating a subgroup in it, that is NIT. Here the profile will be teacher. The teacher has given the right to grade. Now the two groups are created. First is institution based, that is the main group, and a subgroup, that is NIT. Now we will create a topic. In the subgroup, the topic will be shown. That is algorithm is here, is created. Also show the members. See, five members have joined. We can change the the default right role. We can change. We are creating Sumit as TA of that institute. Now Sumit is a TA and he can create assignments, create poll and everything, and create a teacher. The teacher is given the right of grading in view.
So basically I think we can set up any model you want. NIT Agartala can run it its own way. Okay, have 10 teachers, 5 teachers, 1 teacher. Who will grade, who will not grade is their business. What they will add is their business. CS101, what is the parent will get promoted there. Okay, the subgroup can have its own method. Okay, and manage it. And all the metrics that are available for everybody is available for the subgroups as well. So that is the idea, to create completely flexible thing. Okay, so I believe that we can actually do model any method of learning.
These are some of the challenges we faced while making this application. In configuring the Jitsi Meet, which is an external API for video conference, in configuring external forum, JForum, with our platform, and making it very flexible. These are some of the things we've learned. We used the Struts framework for building this application. We used Ajax, we used MySQL for database, HTML, CSS for front end, and Java. And the future scope is that this application could be made even more flexible. Right now, subgroups have only one level, so it could be made more multi-level. Groups, notes, assignments, etc. can be made deletable, and the analytics of each tool can be expanded, and more tools can also be added. So thus, we were successful in creating a flexible web application which has a lot of use cases. Thank you.
Yes. So why you did not use OpenEdX itself?
Sir, it has to be integrated with OpenEdX.
Okay, forget OpenEdX. Moodle, actually many of the things that you have is already there in Moodle. Actually, have you seen? Only the institute part is not there. Rest everything is there. Creating groups and yeah.
Moodle supports that learning, online learning platform, like training an online employee for, an organization can train its employees. Moodle does not support that.
What?
Training of an online employee.
Why?
Sir, it does not have the video conferences and all.
What?
So actually the flexibility.
Video conferencing is one thing, right? You have done so many things. So video conferencing one thing. So you could have built it in Moodle. That's what I'm saying. See, you have built a platform from scratch. That's what I see. And the learning analytics that you showed me, you first said that the objective is to show analytics based on languages. Okay, so how do you compare them? How do you compare Marathi, Hindi, programmers? Where is the analytics for comparison?
Sir, that analytics will go to the main group, no? The subgroups that are Marathi, English, Hindi, they will go to the main group. The analytics will be.
So the analytics which you showed me is course based. Yes, not group based.
So group, like whole group based. The parent group based.
Yes. So how do I identify who has performed better or what?
In the parent group.
but you, I don't think you showed something like that.
That was in the written phase, like we have to put all the things that went from the subgroup
okay.
to the parent group.
Okay. Okay, so you have displayed lot of analytics and this and that. So how do you know which is to be used and which is not to be used by the user? Or you have just thought that this is important?
So
like number of polls, I just want to display. Yeah. Whatever data is available in your system, you want to display.
No, sir.
Is it
like
something like that?
No, it's like,
so who took that decision? What is to be displayed and what is not to be displayed?
So like owner.
Because I see so many things are displayed. So that may distract me also. If I'm conducting that course, maybe I want only certain portion which I would be more interested. And if you give me more and more options, I may get distracted. So where is the problem? So if I want to know if this class is doing, so can a system say that the problem is here, here, here? Three problems. Problem, people are not understanding. So rather than going everywhere, if I have a dashboard which says that this is the problem here, this is the problem here, and this is the problem, very critical. Do you have something called as critical? Do you have something called as moderate? Moderate and good, I need not check, right? So I would like to see what is more critical, what's happening.
The owner of the group, who has created the groups and who is managing all the groups.
Yeah.
So there is the owner. So he can just create a poll like who is performing well.
No. So finally it has to be aggregated. Aggregated in a sense, most important things I would like to put it on my dashboard. Other things I may not be interested. So how do I choose that? Is there a facility to choose or? So that's what I'm saying. So I'll have to spend more time in going through those things which I may not be interested, right? Or if you have asked any teacher or maybe a practitioner who teaches, you know, so that person would be able to tell you what is more important and what is less important. So if you can do that study, it's a nice platform, I liked it. But in my opinion, I would say that if you had used Moodle or OpenEdX to some extent. I know you can use LTI and put it in, you can do that. But I think the information is right inside the core databases. So using LTI will be totally outside, right? I mean, then that means that you are going to access the core databases from your platform, which is not a good solution. So your information is in the core, heart of the system, right? And you want to explore that information, right? So the platform which is available, is already available, is OpenEdX and Moodle. And to choose one of them, you'll have to take a decision. I'm not saying this is not a good platform. There have been many platforms which have come, like Blackboard and lot of Piazza. Have you heard of Piazza?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you can do lot of things in Piazza also.
That restricts to
Piazza,
restricts to your institute, like,
yeah, so
you institute, a whole institute way,
right,
like the company cannot interact in that.
Right, what is your plus point is institute, different institute access to the system, that is your plus point, right? So that plus point, what I am saying is, you could have built on top of Moodle. No, but how will you integrate? It's a completely different system.
You should be flexible. I should be able to add a tool. Whatever is the metrics of the tool, you will capture. Okay. Now, yeah, I understand. Now, what you are saying is, the second question that you said, what they have not done, is the flexibility of choosing analytics. Completely valid point. Okay. Like they are choosing different roles. Okay. I should be able to create a dashboard. It's for you to know. Okay. So it's like a creation of a dashboard. Okay. Depending on Dr. Pathak may want only one matrix, he may want 10. Unfortunately for them, okay, their mentor does not believe in any matrix. Okay. He does not believe in any analytics. But since some people like Dr. Pathak want to understand who has seen what video, okay, we have to build a tool for the general public, we have to give that. Okay. Their mentor believes in only one thing. Okay, a standard good assessment okay, which tells me whether the fellow has learnt or not and how much he has learnt. There is no other metric which I have ever believed in, okay, because I never attended any classes anyway, okay, and I keep telling, this is not the first time anybody who talks about analytics and your group may come and talk about analytics. They will fail me, because I don't attend a single class, okay.
Why need analytics?
No, I don't need analytics as a teacher, but some stupid teachers need, no. So what we have to do is, let him find out who, how many people have seen my mug. I have never seen any teacher's mug, yaar. If some teacher wants to see, he will say zero. I have met teachers who have said that I have not seen you in class. Fortunately, he didn't fail me. But that doesn't mean he would have ever seen me in class. No, that's okay. But that answers your metrics question. Okay, you got a valid point. Okay, their charter was to capture all analytics of the tool, not to make any call, because they are writing a package. A packager does not make a call based on everybody's requirement. A packager will give the flexibility of Dr. Fatak to see what he wants to see. That is something which they have not done. Okay. Second question was Moodle and this thing. They are not building a learning management system. They are not. Okay. That is not their objective. Their objective is to enhance the effectiveness of a current learning management system by providing a slicing and dicing. That there is a group learning environment. Okay. So, correct. So I'm coming to that. Now, I am not going to have any of my interns, okay, waste their precious 8 weeks of time trying to understand, okay, any open source system and modify it. I don't do that. I never done it and I will not do it. Okay. I prefer that they build things on their own. They have used Jitsi, they have used some open source, but they were never supposed to modify it. So they will never modify any tool. Okay. It was purposely kept that they will not integrate. Okay. Though their framework is supposed to be integratable, again I am calling it integratable with OpenEDX and Moodle. That is known.
How, okay, integratable?
They don't know and they will not know. Okay. Because there is no time to waste. Okay. It is a complete waste of time. Okay. I will not have them write any APIs.
Fine.
Okay,
fine,
if
fine.
I ask them to write APIs, fine. They will write some APIs, then show them. This is the API. Okay, what will I do with the API?
So I have another question.
Okay, so basically, it is extending. Okay, the concept of OpenEDX groups. Okay, so now all these stupid people have got a means. Everybody is going group learning system. Okay.
Right.
Because that is the problem with your open learning environment. Okay. But there are all kinds of funny rules.
Right.
Okay. That one person can belong to only one group. Why can't we I have participate in Hindi programmer, learn programming through English, through Hindi, also participate in a straggler group where there are some more assignment given, also participate in some other group which is only for pointers. Where is that flexibility? That I personally believe, okay, that in the age of your online learning environments, where you are expected to have 10,000 heterogeneous students, okay, learning in a single system, okay, where one size fits all is model always breaks down. It breaks down for 60 people. How will it survive for 10,000? So when I'm using this online platforms, okay, to do MOOC, massive open online systems, I need, it's a basic need for me to be able to slice and dice that in variety of ways, and offer that. Now these systems, I'm not going to wait for EDX to do that. I will not change my basic principle. I will not change the horrible OpenEDX. I will not change the horrible Moodle.
Don't change.
I will not change because it is very difficult for me to learn. Correct. If they are here for 1 year, they will do it.
Okay.
They are not here for 1 year, they are here for 8 weeks. I don't want them to spend time at the end of the 8 weeks. I have learned the Moodle database. Nobody is going to hire them to learn in the Moodle database. Okay. They have to learn something here. So that was outside the scope. So it is the part of this gang of mentors, okay, they are supposed to integrate whatever they have done,
Right. With either Moodle or OpenEDX, I leave it to them.
So I
but that
totally
is only to show that it can be done. Yes.
So I totally agree. In the sense, what I see, okay, from your system, okay, and the talk, I mean, you know, the lot of information.
Because Moodle also does not allow me to manage a subgroup.
Correct. Okay. So
my way.
What I see is that the two systems will exist parallelly. That's what you're
saying. Yes.
So let the main system remain.
Correct.
And this is an additional system which is going to help.
And we will have to build on APIs. Okay. If we want to integrate OpenEDX, they will have to study what is there, how I will create a group, how the group information from here will go there, how the information, what information will grow, what information.
So
it is a study. Yaar. Wo, so wo study karne ko time nahi lagta hai.
Let them not study. 6 months are there, December, till December.
No. They have not failed. They are not going to work.
Okay. There is one more thing which you may be interested because they should be interested in knowing is when you talk about scale, 50 million, you know, or more than that, the system has to survive.
Perfect.
So that
very good question. Okay. So that is probably the reason they are not part of Moodle. Okay. Because they are not scalable. Okay. There's no way they are scalable and they will not be scalable because they are based on certain technology.
No.
Okay.
See what I see. See, if you see edX being used, you know, quite number of institutions, they are very less. But if you see a combination of different platforms which are used, some people using edX, some people using Moodle, some people using something else. But your platform is good, right? So what you would want this platform to be penetrated everywhere in different institutions. I mean, that is what you are looking for. You are looking for customers who can buy your platform.
Okay. Ah, good. So their specification, okay. No, their specification was, okay, implement me something which their last fellow, that online trainer, okay, can do. That is the requirement which they are managing, okay. I have to limit their requirements. Okay, so we said we'll take the simplest use case, okay, single person who wants to train some 10 number of people, okay. To answer your question of scalability, I have removed because they were supposed to give me some sort of a product which is demonstrable, I have removed all complications of scalability, etc. Okay. And interaction. All that is, so this is supposed to be, this is part of their charter. Okay. Their reason for existence of the NME ICT group, okay, is that they will fulfill Dr. Fatak's requirement of an open source contribution. Okay. So this is their charter. So they have got about 50% of the work done by them. Rest of them, they have to continue. Okay, so it will be an open EDX solution. Okay, because that is Dr. Fatak's charter. It will be open source. That is Dr. Fatak's charter. Okay, so that is what they are. Dr. Fatak pays them. He does pay them also, but nominal. Okay, so this is their job to meet Dr. Fatak's criteria and they will do it. It's only a step towards that. Okay. This will also be open source after they do some testing and all. I don't know what testing.
Probably. They can also join.
I don't expect any interns to keep working. Okay. I will get some people to work. Okay. But rarely. Only with personal influence. Otherwise, why should they? They have got their life ahead here.
You don't want them to join?
No, I don't. Join what?
Group activity.
No. If they join, it's welcome, okay. But if he joins and he doesn't join, I think he's doing better in life. Let us be clear. No, seriously. Okay. You got your future ahead of you. You have learned something here, use it outside. Okay. Don't get caught in the same well. Okay. Use whatever you are learning. Do something else outside. There are some people I will call on to deliver for me, but that is different. Okay, if they do. Right? Yeah.
Thank you.